Assalamu alaikum. Many times we tell people to do things and we do the opposite. That's not good enough. My brothers and sisters, strengthen yourselves. أَتَأْمُرُونَ النَّاسَ بِالْبِرِّ وَتَنْسَوْنَ أَنفُسَكُمْ وَأَنْتُمْ تَتْلُونَ الْكِتَابِ. In Surah Al-Baqarah, Allah gives an example and Allah says, are you instructing people to do good and you forget yourselves? And yet you're reading Revelation, you're reading the book. Subhanallah. So, in society and community, when you're instructing people and saying things, try to lead by example. Yes, you're a human being. You may falter, but it shouldn't be a habit. You might make a mistake or two. At times, we pay a heavy price for mistakes we've made. But remember, my brothers and sisters, if we make it our business to try our best to practice upon what we preach, we will actually empower people and they would be able to take our message with greater seriousness than if we were the opposite of what we preached. And this is why it's of utmost importance that we ask Allah to strengthen us and to help us to practice upon what we preach. May Allah strengthen all of us and make us from those who can put into practice what we've learned before we actually preach it. But there is a question. If you have a weakness, I'm going to give you an example of smoking. Are you allowed to tell others not to smoke? The answer is yes, you are. Even though you might have the weakness, you can tell your children, look, I'm an addict. I'm addicted to this. I know it's wrong, but I don't want you guys to do it. And you know what? I am not allowing it in this house. But you need to promise yourself and promise Allah that you will quit it as soon as possible. Any bad habit that you don't like for others should not be correct for you. And if there is a bad habit that you're engaged in, please never encourage others to participate in it. Don't ever say, well, I'm smoking, you can smoke. No, I'm committing this sin so you can commit it. It's okay. Don't ever say that, because in that case, you earn a sin for everyone who follows that bad example that you're setting, the bad teaching and the bad instruction. You will get a reward, you'll get a sin because you pointed them towards something that was bad and you encouraged it. And Allah says, وَتَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْبِرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى وَلَا تَعَاوَنُوا عَلَى الْإِثْمِ وَالْعُدْوَانِ. Encourage each other and help each other when it comes to righteousness and piety, goodness, good things, things that will please Allah. And don't encourage each other. Don't help each other when it comes to sin and enmity. Don't. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has warned us. And the simple reason, when you tell people to do good, and if they do the good, you will earn a reward not only for having told them, but for everyone who practices upon it until the day of judgment. And if you were to tell people to do bad, you get a sin for telling them to do bad. Then you get a sin for everyone who followed the bad and everyone from that who told others to do the same bad. And it goes on and on. Which one do you want? And this is why we say, learn to practice what you preach, especially the good that you teach. And may Allah strengthen all of us and grant us ease. أقول قولي هذا والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله.